Welcome to video 2 of our TWedge tutorial series. TWedge supports device connection via serial interface, Bluetooth, TCP, UDP, or USB. When appropriate, TWedge offers client-server, respectively, master-slave operation. In this video, we're going to have a closer look at the individual interface settings. First of all, TWedge is able to communicate with serial devices in a bi-directional way. The basic parameters like port number, speed, the number of data bits, and handshaking options are adjustable. A virtual port is a port which is not available as hardware but simulated by software. If supported by the device driver, TWedge can be instructed to detect and to recover lost connections. You can customize the reconnection logic by way of scripting, but more details about that in the upcoming tutorials. TWedge can also be operated as a TCP client or as a TCP server. The server mode is intended for exactly one simultaneous client connection. The port number the server is providing is adjustable. When operating as a TCP client, the host name of the IP address as well as the port number of the target need to be configured. In order to detect lost connections in a shorter time frame, enable TCP Keepalive handling. If you want TWedge to recover or reopen lost connections automatically, activate the option. UDP is another protocol supported by TWedge. It is used to send or receive pieces of information, so-called datagrams. It is similar to TCP. But as UDP is not a connection-based protocol, no options for connection recovery or keep alive are available. TWedge also provides native support for Bluetooth devices utilizing the serial port profile named SPP. The use of virtual COM ports is no longer required. Please note that the Bluetooth device must be paired with a PC before it can be used by TWedge. If TWedge works as a Bluetooth client, you only need to adjust the device name or the Bluetooth MAC address of the target device. Because Bluetooth devices may get out of range, it is recommended to adjust connection recovery. TWedge can also operate as Bluetooth server. Other Bluetooth clients, like smartphones, can establish a Bluetooth SPP connection to the PC. As a unique highlight, TWedge is able to collect data from USB HID devices connected to a PC. Data from keyboards, or, much more interesting in our case, USB keyboard wedge scanners can be intercepted and processed. To prevent Windows from handling device data like normal keyboard import, select the option Suppress Keystrokes. Then the data is only processed by TWedge. If required, the keyboard layout in use by the USB HID device can be adjusted as well. The null device is intended for testing purposes only and provides no configuration options at this time. TWedge is able to manage multiple devices in parallel. This will be demonstrated in our next video. Thanks for watching!